two former World Cup participants looking for potential national players in England? Football under difficult conditions, because even the national players have to work during the day so that they can then pursue their hobby. All this shapes football in Anguilla. Today we talk about it. We're going all the way down in the FIFA world rankings to second last place. We head to the Caribbean, to the British overseas territory of Anguilla. But make no mistake, the poor ranking does not mean there is no football enthusiasm there. Just over 14,000 inhabitants, an area of about 96 square kilometers and regular hurricanes to contend with. Not exactly the best prerequisites for playing a major role in Caribbean football. But the dreams are big, and national coach Stern John, after all a World Cup participant with Trinidad and Tobago in 2006, has already moved things in the right direction. But let's start, as always, with the history of football in Anguilla. As in many countries in the Caribbean, football has to get in line behind cricket in terms of popularity. There, they are part of the West Indies, but in football they operate independently. The British occupiers once brought football to Anguilla and established it there. The Football Association was founded in 1990 and Anguilla joined Concacaf in 1994. 2 years later, in 1996, it was decided to join FIFA and football began to develop on the small island. In 1997, the AFA Senior Male League was launched and Spartans International secured its first title. To this day, there is only this one league on Anguilla, so no leagues below that form the base. Time and again, there are problems in the AFA League, and a negative highlight was certainly the withdrawal of Roaring Lions FC in the 2015-16 season due to the lack of opportunities for players and the stagnation of the sport in the country. The league is completely at amateur level, as our current insider, national player Jonathan Guishard, confirms to us.
So as I said before, we have one division with 11 teams. It is a completely amateur league, so there are no professional players here. All the players, we have our own jobs, separate from football. So in Anguilla, we can say that we play football for the love of the sport. Here we play two rounds in the league. Each team play each other twice, and the top four teams have a playoff to decide the winner. We also play a Champions League and a Development League. The Champions League is comprised of the top five teams and the rest make up the D League. We play in a knockout style tournament to determine the winners of each division.
The most important matches in the league are played at Ronald Webster Park, the only stadium on the island, and cricket is also played here. Except for their withdrawal in the 2015-16 season, the Roaring Lions made many positive headlines. They are also the record champions with 8 titles and lead the current table. But the best scorer with 10 goals is our guest today, Jonathan Guishard, who plays for Docks United FC. Although the league is governed by CONCACAF, the teams have not yet participated in international tournaments, neither in the Champions League nor in the Club Championship. There's hope, however, that this will change in the future, as the CONCACAF Champions League will change its mode for the 2023-24 season and start with regional groups. So, there's hope that Anguilla will participate with a team in the Caribbean group. Let's now talk about the national team, which is ranked 209th in the FIFA World Rankings and has long been considered the worst national team in the world. This reputation came from being at the bottom of the rankings for a very long time with little success. But from the beginning, the team played its first international match before the association was founded. In 1985, they lost 0-1 against the British Virgin Islands. The first time they took part in an official tournament was in 1991, the Caribbean Cup. However, they finished last in a group with St. Lucia and Montserrat. In the following years, they never made it past the group stage of the Caribbean Cup. The first time they took part in a World Cup qualifier was for the tournament in Japan and South Korea in 2002. they were eliminated in the first round by the Bahamas. Until now, the team has never managed to get past the first round. For the upcoming World Cup in Qatar, they finished last in Group D without any points. Despite all these bitter results, Jonathan sees a progression over the past few years.
Yeah, so I would say there has been visual progress in the last couple of years with the inclusion of overseas coaches and the investing of more money into the development of football, especially in the younger ages. The coaches bring a wealth of knowledge and experience, especially since some of them are ex-professionals. They know what it takes. They know what is needed to catch up to the rest of the Caribbean.
The association has definitely developed its public image in recent years. The jerseys in particular, for example, are a real insider's tip for collectors. But a real driving force for football is also national coach Stern John, who puts in a lot of work to advance football on the island. One of his first steps was to look for players who play in England and are also allowed to play for Anguilla because of their roots. This has been successful, with some players now playing for Anguilla and raising the standard of the national team to a new level. Although the players are not to be found in the professional leagues in England, but rather in the 9th, 10th league, they nevertheless help with the development. John is supported in his endeavor by his former colleague Brent Sancho, both of whom use their contacts to reach out to even more players. FA president Gordon Connor also helped in the search with a list of all the players who are likely to play for Anguilla because of their ancestry. The team of officials is doing everything possible to ensure that painful defeats like the 0-15 loss to Trinidad and Tobago in 2019 do not happen again. Striker Guishard knows there is still a long way to go, but dreaming is always allowed.
Well, I think it should be every Caribbean player's dream to play in the World Cup because it's one of the highest competitions for our region. Hopefully, if we keep on the right track in terms of the development of football in Anguilla, we can play in the Gold Cup. Maybe not me personally, but I would definitely want to see Anguilla in the Gold Cup.
Maybe we'll even manage to find more players through this video whose roots are on the small Caribbean island and who want to help the team progress further and work their way up in the FIFA World Rankings. Once again, an incredibly exciting nation on our journey around the globe. Did you like it? Then feel free to subscribe to my channel Football Worldwide and follow me on Instagram too. New videos about football in all countries of the world will follow soon. I'm really happy about everyone who is following this journey. Take care, and I hope to see you soon.